All right, today's class will be about refreshing our content. So we're going to refresh some movie genres. Also, we're going to start refreshing adjectives, in this case, comparative adjectives and superlative adjectives. This is the class of today, the 7th of August, with the 9th grade day. Let's continue with today's class. We're going to have a short activity, and then this short activity will have to match the movie genres. Okay, let's go and match movie genres in 1 minute. Let's go. Oh, Shrek. Movie genres. Let's go. Let's match in Nearpod. Out of four mirrors. Action. First to first date. Okay, time is up. Okie dokie, let's see. Wow. Lots of people had everything correct. You guys are very good. So what we had was, this is nothing. So we had now action film, Transformers, animated film, Shrek, a documentary. ¿Cómo se llama este documental? ¿Alguien me ayuda? What's the name of this documentary? The Tiger and this man? Have you seen it in Netflix?
No,
probably not. No, I can't remember. Life of a Tiger? I can't remember. Then we have a comedy. What's the name of this movie, by the way, with the comedy thing?
No sé.
Some corny.
Okay, grown ups. Horror film. We have The Conjuring. Ooh, scary.
I know.
Bueno, good movie. Romantic comedy. 51st Date. Have you seen 51st Date? ¿Alguien lo ha visto?
Yo, profe, pero es más comedia que romántico.
Está como por ahí, sí. Es un romantic comedy. ¿Cuál es la trama? A ver, ¿cuál es la trama?
¿Te ha preguntado a mí?
Yes, dame.
Que una diva chocó en un accidente y todos los días como que se reinicia la mente y no se acuerda de nada. Y este se enamoró de la diva, entonces todos los días trata de enamorarla.
Sí, es bueno. A mí me gusta el plot. El plot es una trama. Es inteligente. Muy inteligente. Thank you, Dahmer. It's a good movie. Son como niños. Todas las que están en Adam Sandler son chistosas. Sí, yo creo igual lo mismo. Me gusta una que se llama Click. Es bacán. La del control remoto. Spy Alien. And then we got finally Thriller. Hasta cómo se llama esta película.
¿Thriller qué es, profe?
Thriller dijimos que es como un tipo de drama, como de generalmente de asesinos, de secuestro, cosas así. Es un thriller. Ah. Ay, no sé cómo se llama esta película. Es que le secuestran la hija. Ah, ¿cómo se llama?
Busca Implacable.
Busca eso.
¿Implacable? ¿Así?
Sí.
Oh, buenísimo. Uy, son secos, gracias. Son secos. Vamos a ver cómo está, se llama en inglés. Porque siempre tiene nombre raro. Taken. Taken.
Profesor.
Qué extraño. Ah, yes.
¿No le duele mirar la RAM de su computador con tantas pestañas en Chrome abiertas?
No. No, anda súper bien, de hecho. Tiene 16 de RAM. Así que hasta ahora funciona bien. Ok. I got another question. This is a survey. Una encuesta. A survey. I want to know, people, which series is the best? You can choose only one. Well, the options are Riverdale, Anne with an E, Game of Thrones, Elite, La jauría. American Horror Story. Rick and Morty. Se podía elegir más de una, pero no se puede.
Profe, pregunta.
Breaking Bad. Mira, Vicente Córdoba. ¿Qué?
Profe.
Yes, Manuel.
¿Usted vio La Jauría?
Oh, no, I haven't seen La Jauría.
Ah, ya.
Es literalmente una parodia de la feminista.
Sí.
Amiga, eres seca.
Oh. I haven't seen it. I have Amazon Prime, so probably I'm gonna try to watch and then give my opinion. But no.
Profe, en uno de los computadores, bueno, al menos la pantalla del computador de la oficina de, creo que es la PDI, sale el mapa del GTA.
¿En serio? ¿El GTA San Andrés?
¿En serio sale el mapa del GTA? ¿Sí?
Me voy a fijar, a ver, qué mal. El último Google Maps.
Y es como lo mismo que hacen en El Chavo del Ocho, ponen actores como de 40 años a ser de alumno de cuarto medio.
Oh, igual les creí el Chavo, pero igual pensaba que era un niño. Hay que ver, veamos qué tal. La tengo que ver para poder opinar. Riverdale, a ver, para mí, ¿cuál es la mejor de aquí? Elijan una, a ver. Profe, no veo ni una chuta.
Ahí el César hizo un video de la Jauría.
Ah, claro, Martina, estoy de acuerdo, sí. Finalmente igual muestra algo que está ocurriendo, así que igual yo creo que por eso se ha vuelto popular.
Rick and Morty, profe.
Pues no la he visto, yo por Game of Thrones. Ya, me mando por Game of Thrones. A ver, vamos a ver las votaciones, a ver cómo está. Ya, vamos votando. Mira, Londres igual se puso un emoji. Bueno. Oye, ¿este que tiene nombre de pueblo asterisco, quién será? Mira, Anne with the Knee tiene muchos fans. Game of Thrones, estoy yo, Nino, ¿quién es Nino?
Antonino.
Mira, buena apodo, es Nino. Bueno, Nino, estamos en el mismo equipo. Nino, Felipe Marín. Felipe Marín, yes, always. ¿Quién va? Elite. Ah, Elite igual tiene sus fans. ¿Quién va por la jauría? Ay, una persona en la jauría, mira. ¿Quién va por American Horror Story? Ah, nadie la ha visto, es buena. ¿Y Rick and Morty? Rick and Morty tiene hartos fans. Nunca la he visto, sí, pero ya se para. All right, so we got now about Emmy goes for Riverdale. Okay, I think Anne with a Knee is the winner, has more votes than any other. Interesting. Anne with a Knee is the most chosen. Wow. So if it is that popular, I need to watch it. All right, let's continue, people. So now we're going to get into the review. Okay, so in the review of today's class, what we're going to be doing is focusing on the last content that we were talking about. This is not the thing. We already did it. Okay, we were talking about the comparatives and the superlatives. So we were mentioning on the previous classes about that we could compare things. Gilbert. We were talking about comparatives and superlatives, and we were checking the rules of it. Can anyone remember how do we compare? Is one with the comparatives is one versus when we use the comparatives? So I say my house is bigger than yours, or if I say my car is yours,
what?
Yes, it's one versus one. So when we use comparatives, it's always one versus one. We mentioned also that we can have short adjectives. Okay, we have short adjectives, and short adjectives, they add er to the to their adjectives. For example, taller than something, stronger than something, smaller than something, bigger. Also, we have short adjectives, that's to say, two-syllable adjectives ending in Y. We have the ER, for example, lazy changes to lazier, happy to happier, merry to merrier, etc. And then we have one-syllable adjectives with the combination of consonant vowel consonant, and that would be one syllable adjectives like fat and big, they double their last consonant, okay? There's another example, the word thin. Thin has one syllable, thin, one syllable. And what we do is we count the last three letters. So this is consonant, this is vowel, and this is consonant again. So what we do is we double again. Thinner, it should be. Or the thinnest, if it is superlative. Okay, so it's the last three words of a one syllable adjective. That is the only requirement, one syllable adjective. It needs to be one syllable, otherwise it doesn't work. One syllable adjective with a combination of CVC, consonant, vowel, consonant. And then to continue, we have the long adjectives. Long adjective, they have two or more syllables, and in the comparative, we add more, like more beautiful, more dangerous, more interesting, more dedicated, more delicate, more amazing, etc. And finally, we have the special adjectives. Special adjectives are irregular adjectives. These adjectives cannot add ER or more with them. We change them completely to, for example, good, we change to better, and bad, we change to worse. Okay, mejor que. Okay. That is the idea of the comparatives. Example, okay, let's do some examples. Let's say that the teacher is taller than Antonino. My house is smaller than my mom's. My cat is lazier than my cat, than my dog. You're happier than, I don't know, someone in the TV. My dog is fatter than my cat. My hamster is bigger than a rat. The trees are more beautiful than flowers. I don't know. Speeding is more dangerous than flying. Pasta is better than rice. And cuchayuyo is worse than rice. Okay. So we're comparing one versus one. So what we're gonna do now is, people, a quiz. Let's do a short quiz on the comparatives. Vamos al quiz. Okay. Questionnaire. Let's go to the quiz. So we're gonna go to the quiz now, and I'm gonna give you, this is six questions. I'm gonna give you, I'm going to give you 4 minutes. To complete this quiz on the comparatives. Alrighty. Okay, I'll be right back. Need to catch some water. If you have questions, remember to ask me the questions. I'll be right back. I'm going to get some glass of water. Okay, let's see the quiz. What's the time? 2 minutes. Oh, okay. Oh, lots of people finished the quiz already. Lucas Valdez, está bien. Martina, Manuel.
Yes, dije.
Que me saben que no han respondido ninguna.
Ah, es que ahora lo estoy haciendo.
Ok. Pablo. No, Pablo ahí sí. Es activo.
¿Por qué aparece Donald Trump al final, profe?
Donald Trump. Ah, nadie le cae bien Donald Trump. Ni su papá lo que. I think most people have finished. Oh, no, not yet. Dale, Fran, tú puedes, vamos. Dale, Anto, tú puedes, vamos. Mm-hmm. Uy, en general vamos súper bien. Vamos súper, súper bien. People, by the end of the month, we will be finishing the unit, okay? By the end of the month. And very soon, around September, we're gonna take a test, okay? Y estamos preparando, por fin, poder poner una nota sumativa. Es decir, una nota que, como ustedes le dicen, iría al libro, ¿ya? Así que lo más probable es que hagamos un trabajo, ¿ya? Hagamos un tipo de trabajo, algún proyecto relacionado con la unidad, ¿ya? Lo vamos a pensar bien y se lo vamos a comunicar. Ah, Tiane, ¿no te agarraba el nombre? ¿En serio? A lo mejor te lo censuró. ¿Cómo te pusiste, Tiane? Es por el Gilbert. Qué raro. Sí, ya se pasa. Yeah, all right, let's go. Let's check. Ya, estoy en Zoom ahora. Tengo aquí mi quiz. Lo vamos a revisar con ustedes. So, Emma's house is more big or bigger?
Bigger.
Bigger, okay. Bigger. Mr. Curva, why bigger? Y no more big.
Consonante, vocal, consonante.
Ya, tiene eso, sí, estoy de acuerdo. Tiene consonante, vocal, consonante. Y eso quiere decir que el adjetivo tiene...
Se le repite la última consonante y se le agrega el er.
Sí, le repetimos la última consonante. Y así como de las sombras, también quiere decir que... Si es que es consonante o el consonante, el adjetivo tiene una sílaba, entonces es considerado corto. Y big no es un adjetivo largo, entonces no puede ir como... Yeah. Goody. Thank you, Mr. Corva. Very precise. Let's call it now. The rose is more beautiful or beautifuler than the daisy?
More beautiful.
More beautiful.
More beautiful. Yeah, ¿por qué?
Porque está comparando.
Claro, las dos están comparando, por supuesto.
Pero... Because beautiful is a large word.
It's a long adjective. It's a long word. Right. Yes, right. A long word. That we have beautiful is No, I'm not mistaken. Where's the erase? The word is... Beautiful. So it's three syllables. 1, 2, and 3. So three syllables is a long adjective. So we need more beautiful because it's long. Alrighty, next. The tiger is more dangerous or dangerouser than the elephant?
More dangerous.
Okay, Joseph, why?
Es un adjetivo largo.
It's a long adjective. Again, it's a long adjective. So we have dangerous. Dangerous. Three syllables. So it's a long adjective. This is the correct one. Then we have vacations on the beach. Vacations on the beach is than vacations on the city. More relaxing or relaxinger? Oh.
More relaxing.
More. Relaxing, again, it's a long adjective. Relaxing, three syllables. Next, the weather in Qatar is hotter than or hotter or more hot than in Beijing.
Letter B.
Y why is B and not A?
Porque la
vocal consonant.
Okay. Thank you too. Now, Maria Ignacia, you can do this one. Thank you, Manuel. Donald Trump is more rich or richer than Michael Jordan?
B.
Why is that, Maria Ignacia?
Porque rich es un adjetivo corto.
Yes, absolutely. Did you know that Mr. Sebastián Piñera is richer than Donald Trump? Surprise, surprise. He's richer than Donald Trump. Wow, that is crazy. He is richer than Donald Trump, man. ¿Cómo puedo conocer el valor del espacio de realidad? Ah, por el largo del adjetivo, oh, man. Mira, me voy a devolver un poquito. Aquí. Dijimos que los adjetivos largos de dos o más sílabas se le anteponen more para poder comparar. ¿Ya? Entonces, relaxing es el adjetivo. ¿Ya? Relajante. Relaxing. Por lo tanto, lo que hay que hacer primero es ver qué le ponemos. R o more. Para eso contamos las sílabas. Relaxing. Tiene tres. Dijimos que lo largo se considera cuando tiene dos o más. ¿Ya? Entonces te tiene tres. Calza con los largos. Y a todos los adjetivos en comparativo, que son largos, se le pone more. Adelante. No le podemos poner R porque eso es solo para los adjetivos que tienen una sílaba. ¿Ya? Así que relaxing no calza con esta descripción de una sílaba. Es por eso. Okidoki. Let's finish the quiz. Let's continue now. So we talked about now. I'm going to share the results. Ahí va el resultado. Para que lo vean en el earbud. Yo diría que en general estamos súper bien. ¿Ya? Vamos a poder hacerlo muy bien en la evaluación formativa. Que viene a fin de mes. So let's continue now with the other thing. Okay. N is the superlatives. So we have to understand this. We need to understand the following thing. We have comparison. Okay. Comparison. This is the general concept. Comparaciones. Okay. This is the general concept. And then subconcepts of comparison. We have different types, okay? We have like three types of comparatives. We have the comparatives, the comparativos, que acabamos de ver. Ah, igual he mejorado. Comparatives. And then we have the superlatives. De como doctor. Superlatives. And then we have the equal comparative, el comparativo de igualdad. Que lo revisamos así, hicimos una pincelada nomás la clase anterior. Y después lo vamos a meter más ahí. Okay, so the thing is that in this general concept, everything is comparison. Todos son comparaciones, son comparaciones de distintos. So comparatives is one versus one. What about the superlative? What is the difference between the comparative and the superlative? Beautiful question. Oh, I need to connect the computer to the electric current. What would be the difference, people? In this case, is one versus, if I say the Ferrari is the most beautiful car.
Uno destaca sobre otro.
Oh my God. Uno destaca sobre otro. Uno destaca sobre un
conjunto.
Yes.
Conjunto o un grupo.
Yes, very nice, very nice. So, well said, María Ignacia and my friend. It's one versus the group, okay? So one highlights or one remarks above the other. So we have one thing that we are comparing versus a group of other things. So it's a bit similar to the comparatives, but in the case of the superlatives, we need the EST and also we need most, okay? The most, EST. So one syllable adjective, again, we add ST. For example, the cleanest animal is the cat. Okay. Also, we can say we have two. Estos son cortos, por si acaso. Short adjectives. So considerado corto. Two syllable adjectives ending in Y. We change Y for EST, so it's the busiest or the happiest student in the class is Antonino, el más feliz. And then we have long adjectives que están aquí. Que están acá. Right. Long adjective. And long adjectives, they use the word most. The most dangerous animal in the planet is. No sé cuál es. Maybe snake, maybe a spider. The most dangerous. Let's say the most interesting country in the world is Brazil. Okay. Or the most active student in the class is Benjamin Bio and his brother. I'm María Ignacia, because they play volleyball. El opuesto de the least, de the most, es the least. The most es el más y the least es el menos. No vamos a ocupar mucho the least, pero es bueno saberlo. Que podemos decir lo contrario, como el menos rápido o el menos activo. Para eso se ocupa the least. Okay. Y aquí faltó una categoría. Irregular adjectives. Faltó eso. No lo pusieron en este recuerdo. ¿Quién recuerda cuáles eran? People, the irregular adjectives. Voy a ponerlo acá abajito. Irregular, the special adjectives, the special.
Best, worst.
Very nice. Perfect. So we have the best. Anga me dijo the worst. El otro es más lejano que furthest, pero quizá no se ocupa tanto. The best and the worst. Okay, so is that's the way we do it. So the best food is pizza. So from all the foods, all the different foods in the world, pizza is the best. Okay. Let's see a bit of a short quiz. Vamos a un pequeño quiz otra vez para refrescar. Bim, 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 bim. With the superlatives. Vamos allá. Vamos a darle igual. Al mismo tiempo. Four minutes. Here we go. Vamos al Nearpod, al quiz. No way, wow, so many people have everything correct. Oh, qué bueno, ay, man. Voy a terminar el día bien, muy contento porque le está yendo muy bien. Con los quiz. Prometo, me la voy a sacar de la mano. Hey, what's up? ¿Cuál es tu problema?
My problem?
What? What was that all about? Oh, what's the problem, man? Oh, dude.
What? If you want to fight, I'm here with all my homies.
No, pero yo no la he hecho web. No, yo no la estoy haciendo. Ah, ya entiendo. Thank you, baby. Goody. Okay, but no worries. Let's have a go. Ya, me voy ahora a near, me voy al Zoom otra vez, ahora a corregir. Antonino, let's go and check. Who is the tallest or who is the most tall person in your family?
Es Tales.
The tallest.
Ena.
Ah, yeah. Joseph, what's the most dangerous or what's the dangerous animal in the world?
Most dangerous.
The most dangerous. Why? ¿Por qué?
Porque dangerous tiene tres sílabas.
Oh, Joseph, very good.
Tenían más de tres, eran most o yeah. More, lo que sea.
Claro, no, es the most. En este caso estamos trabajando en superlativo, así que es the most. Good, perfect. Antonio Carvalho. Ethan is the happiest boy I know. The happiest.
Be happiest.
Happiest, yes. We have to change the Y for a I. And then, where are the beaches in your country? Maito Gaido. The most nice or the nicest?
La B.
La B. Yes. Because it's short adjective. Let's continue with the other thing. Who is the most famous or the famous test, Felipe Marin?
Is the most famous.
The most famous Felipe Marin. Why?
Porque tiene más de dos sílabas. Una adjetiva largo.
No, es Felipe Marin. Pierre Moreno, she bought the biggest house, the most big, or the biggest house, which is the correct? The biggest cake in the shop, sorry. Oh, I'm gonna clear the chat. Letter C, the biggest, yes. The most big, no, because it's short. And it's consonant, vowel, consonant, so we double the G. Yes, okay, Redis, very nice. Lo que cheque están haciendo. Is mostly correct. Okay, let's go to the final activity then. Final activity. Vamos a ver quién llega a la cima y domina la cima. Let's play it in the space now. All right. Let's play it in the space. Yes. Ya está. Oh, la M apareció. A ver, ¿qué voy a hacer yo? Quiero hacer un...
Profe, me petó el Nearbot.
¿Ah?
Me petó el Nearbot.
¿Se te cerró?
No pesca.
Ah, ya, déjalo.
No
que...
lo puedo reiniciar.
Déjalo, parece que está cargando.
No sé, el mensaje que dice Nearbot.com tardó demasiado en responder.
Oh, a ver, te mando el link otra vez entonces. Aquí te va.
Okay.
Sí, porque a lo mejor pueden ganar. Copiar. Let's see. Okay, there you go. We have 25 people ready for the contest. Oh, hay muchos pingüinitos. Hay muchos pingüinitos. Venga, con el Guido somos iguales. Somos una llama. Con el Vicente Córdoba igual. Somos una llama espacial. Hello. Oh, ¿quién es? Bernie, unos. Diego is a fox. Abelu is a fox. A giraffe, Emmy. El Nino is a turtle, I think. Y la Kona, Kona. Es un buen apodo. Voy a intentar pensar alguno para verlo. Lelu. Ya. Emanuel, ¿ready?
Sí.
Uh-huh. En mi check. Ah, me faltan. Falta gente. Muy poquito. Pero falta. Two people. It's two people. Yeah, let's go. No sé quiénes serán los que no están. Vamos a hablar. Pero vamos a empezar más. Okay, let's begin. Yeah, okay, make sure you choose the correct question. Read well. We add the ST to make superlative form of any adjective. We never change the spelling before an adjective ER. Spelling es cómo se escribe. Dice, nunca cambiamos cómo se escribe un adjetivo cuando le agregamos ER o ST. Good question. Nunca se cambia. We often use then after the comparative adjective. My house is bigger than me. Number five. We often use the before the superlative. I'm the strongest man in the world, I'm the biggest, or whatever. Cool. Message. Boom. With longer adjectives, we use more and most with an adjective. The long adjectives. The clothes are than in my town. This is my mi peor nota, la peor. That's the meal I ever had. That's the la más asquerosa. They're in the school than the old one. Están más felices. Están comparando entre las dos escuelas. Bye. Hoy el Mike Toga ha ido, por eso le dicen Mike Toga ha ido. Oh, spaghetti sauce. Delicious. Your spaghetti sauce is not mine. Oh, what's wrong? Yeah, Lord. Let's see. So we have a winner. We have Mr. Guido Manuel and Vincent Cordova. Also, Antonio Carlin, Belen Contreras, Felipe Marin, Mary Ignacia, Daniel, Nino, Bibi, Joe, Alondra, Tiara, Emmy, Anto, Diego, Vicente, Joseph, and many, many more. Vamos a que cero, chuta. Okay, people, so what we're gonna do is the following thing. Are you there? ¿Están ahí todavía? Hello?
Yes.
profe.
Sí, teacher.
Ah, okay. Right, people. So, next week we're gonna work in groups, okay? In a material to practice and reinforce, okay? So I won't give you homework now. The next week we are going to work in a homework in the class, in groups. The groups can be of 3 people. So for next class, think about the name of your group, okay? The names of the people for your group. 3 people maximum, okay? Maybe 4 people maximum. So think about that, and the next class is all group work. Thank you for being here, connected, and you are incredible. 33 people, you were great. Only 4, yes, Antonia. Some questions sometimes are confusing, but you did very well. I'm sure that in the formative test, it will be super good. Alrighty, people, so that's the end of the class. I guys, see you next week, and enjoy your weekend. I see you next time.
Thank you, teacher.
See you next time.
Bye, guys. Teacher.
See you, my girl.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye,
teacher.
See ya.